Drums, please.
Miami.
Good morning to the vlog.
I only came for 2 days of playing, but every time I come, I always wind up staying. Going to Miami.
Alright, what's up, guys? And now I'm currently in Miami Beach. I'm so excited. I'm currently at this like parking lot place. There's been a lot of standoffs, people fighting over parking spaces. This parking space is on Collins Avenue and 13th Street. It's only like $1 an hour until a certain time, and then it goes to $2 an hour. Really cheap compared to like literally all the other parking places that are here in Miami, because I don't know, they're like $10 for like an hour stuff. Oh, OOTD. This shirt is a knockoff Versace shirt from Urban Outfitters. I love it so much. I'm getting like J-Lo, like French Montana vibes. And then shorts, my regular shorts, and then my Nikes, just because I'm gonna be walking a lot. If you guys don't know, I haven't been to Miami Beach since like 2014. Like, it's been the longest time, and the last time I came was for Beyonce and Jay-Z. So that whole entire story, I'll leave a link like up above to us talking about that story. It wasn't too great, but the funny thing is that we stayed at the Fontainebleau, which is literally one of my favorite hotels in the world. And the day that we checked out was the day that J-Lo was gonna be performing at the hotel. And I remember having FOMO because I wanted to go so badly. So yeah, but I'm just gonna spend like probably 2 hours here at the beach just to explore. I don't know, I don't really like beaches, if you guys don't know that about me, but I just wanted to kind of see it. About to explore a little bit, and I'll catch up with you guys soon. Alright guys, so this right here is Ocean Drive. It's literally world famous, and actually that hotel over there, I have a funny story. So when me and my mom came last time, okay, like this girl right here, like oh my god, like people just like have like their tops off. I don't know. Last time we were here, my mom was like, Tywan, close your eyes. Cause it was like a balcony over there. And this girl like just had like our stuff out. And it was just like, girl, put that away. Like, come on. Like, I get you're at Miami Beach, but you don't gotta put that out there. Like, oh. I was about to hop this little thing and head to the beach. Oh, how am I gonna do this? We just put it like that. Okay. This is fun. Oh my god, I see water. Guys, I love tropical destinations. I don't know what it is. Maybe I'll like sit down later to like really give you guys like the tea on why I don't like beaches. It's just like always crowded, and then like I never get into the water because it's either cold or like once again crowded. Even in Hawaii, like I didn't have the best time. Oh my god, it's such a beach. And I love these shoes because like the sand just like gets out as soon as possible. But I have to touch the water since I'm here. I'm like sending boomerangs out to people. People are like, what are you doing in Miami? I'm like, I'm just having a great time. Figured out why I don't like the beach, guys. Because I'm not photogenic on the beach. Like, I look great right now, but for some reason, like, with like all the elements of like water and wind and like me trying to like look sexy or whatever, it's like, it just doesn't work out. Anyways, I was walking past all these people on the beach. They're like listening to J-Lo like it's 1999. There is something about Miami that just like, I don't know, feels like J-Lo's universe. I don't know. I hope they have like a place to wash your feet off, because I don't want to walk down Ocean Drive like this. And that girl was so nice to take my picture. Thank you so much. Okay guys, back on Ocean Drive. I just love this. This is so quaint and great. And these hotels are rich AF. Okay, I spotted Starbucks. Thank you. What's up guys, got my drink. It's the new mango dragon fruit. It's actually really good. It just has like a lot of sugar in it, so I don't always get it, but oh, I was so thirsty. Now I really don't know what I'm doing. I have 2 more hours for the parking space. I may rent one of those bikes.
I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I'm gonna walk this way to see if there's something else I can do. And talk to you guys soon.
Guys, this is the hotel for one of my favorite movies of all time. There's Something About Mary.
She puts the hair gel in her hair.
Is that a hair gel? Great.
Yeah, No, you don't have to.
I just ran out.
I'm literally freaking out. There's Something About Mary. It's so cool.
I'm only in the Cardoza Hotel.
This is so cool. What was in There's Something About Mary? And some other films too. Garden of Eden. I don't know any films. I don't even know what film this is. So it's like historic and like legendary. This is so cool, guys. Oh my god. I just love Ocean Drive so much because they have like different hotels here. So like, look at all these people like just eating. It's so cool. It's kind of like Vegas in a way, but smaller hotel.
Shoo shoo. Shoo shoo.
Oh my god, what? Guys, I think that this is the Versace mansion from Assassination of Versace. Right there, that's so cool. Guys, I just got pictures. Oh my God, these are actually pretty good in front of the Versace mansion. This is so cool, I'm gonna post these to my Instagram. Thank you again. Thanks. This is so cool. Oh my God, that's... People are playing Ricky Martin, like his album just came out. It's like an outdoor club thing. I love clubs, guys. I'm never like around my friends whenever I want to go to the club. Or like they're working or something weird's always happening. This is beautiful.
This is Macho Beach.
Two tickets to the gun show. I am sweating. You'll never see me shirtless. Unless I'm being paid for it. She'll be on a TV show or something.
All right, guys, so it's dusk. Everybody's heading to the bars and to the clubs out here just because the water's getting cold.
It's been an amazing day in Miami. For some reason, my pants keep on, like, shrinking down. I don't know why. But this lady, she was just the nicest to me. She just took all these pictures of me in front of, like, the Miami Beach little thing over there, so that was really nice. I'm gonna find a sunset spot, maybe. I don't know. I really need to get to the gym tonight. I just have a lot to do, and I don't know if I want this shirt still, even though I kind of sweated a little bit, but... Miami Beach, so happy. And I'm so sad my mom's not here, but I'll fill you guys in a little bit later on why she's not here. So, yeah. Oh, so tropical, guys. There's like people walking on the other side, so I have to like run into the branches or whatever.
See, guys, look at this, $25 for parking. No way.
A few moments later.
Why'd you start talking as soon as I pull out a camera?
All right, what's up, guys? Sweaty AF. It is like 94 degrees out there. And this shirt like isn't breathable. I don't know. It's just not the greatest. Charging my phone back up so I'd know how to get back to the hotel. I think I'm gonna go to this like sunset, like lookout point. I think it's called like Sunset Point Park or something like that. It's just like 10 minutes down the road. So I'm gonna check that out. I went to the Cardozo Hotel. I was so excited. You guys have no idea. Like, I just love seeing places that like movies took place in, and there's something about Mary.
Underpants.
Sorry about the stuff in the back. It's the beach life. That's what you do. You just like throw all your like your trash in the back. So I'm about to go work out, go see part of the sunset hopefully, and then head back to the hotel. So I'm really excited about it. And I put a lot of stuff on my Instagram story, more than I usually do, just because I don't vlog on my Instagram story like most people do, just because I'm getting footage from this camera. So if you guys want to check out my Instagram story, like follow me on Instagram or whatever. And yeah, just such a great time. As soon as my phone turns back on, I'm out of here. Talk to you guys soon. Bye. Love you. I don't know, I always feel like Miami is like just Latin and like just amazing. Oh no! Such a bomb! So good! How many songs you do so far?
Like 10.
I had a bug in here while I was gone. It's kind of creepy. Like, it's really, it's bigger than I thought, like that leg. But I'm about to just, you know, let him free into Miami.
No, the folder don't fit on under the whole
fold. Okay, I'll tell you guys when the bug's gone, because it's stressful.
Later.
All right, what's up, guys? So it's much later in the day. I'm currently watching Euphoria. I don't know if you can see the Zendaya show. It's so good. Went to audition for this really bad. I like wrote the casting director of the show or whatever. It's kind of cold. That's why I'm doing this. And my hoodies are in the wash. So I'm like kind of disguised like this. Like a little ET, like a little babushka. But I love this show so far. It's so like real and just reminds me of, I don't know, kind of like what my high school experience was like. I mean, I didn't go out as much as these characters do, but I know first, second, and third hand like what people experience, and it's so crazy how just close to vest it is. I don't know, it makes me happy that real stories are being made like this, with African-American characters in the forefront. So I'm just really happy about that. I hope to be a part of a project that's like really cool like this one day. The only thing I care about is being in stories that people love, that people
can really relate to, like Euphoria. Tomorrow's Monday, so I find out. Okay, I need to pause this because it's getting good. Tomorrow's Monday, and I just need to do my like Sunday night prayer because, you know, it's the first business day of the week, and I find out just like a lot of stuff, like a lot of life-changing stuff usually on Mondays. Anyways, I'm gonna end the vlog here in my bed. I'll give you guys a room tour probably tomorrow. This is like my room. It's just like the TV there. That's a closet. It's a closet over there. My H&M bag that I bought today. That's like to the outside. That is to the front door in the kitchen, and then this is to my own bathroom. I'll be sure to give you guys a tour sometime tomorrow night when housekeeping comes in and like cleans up the room, so that I can give you guys like an actual like suite tour, because it's an amazing villa. And I'm so sorry once again that I can't necessarily tell you guys like why I'm here, but I will at some point. And once again, it's just family stuff. It's not like for acting or anything like that. Like, just helping family out with like medical things. So I love you guys forever for following my acting journey. I know it's long, and you know, it's been almost 3 years. It'll be 3 years in August from when I started this channel. So I know it's been a long journey, but I thank you guys so much for sticking with me and hanging out with me every single day. But I hope I hear back from the really big audition that I had. God, that was last week. It's just crazy to think about. And I hope everything works out in my life, you know. I'm just really proud to be in this body and to be living it. I'm not gonna cry, but I just thank God for this life. You know, it's a practice in patience, but I swear to God, I know that something worthwhile is coming, and I can feel it. It's like revving up. I feel so energetic, so much adrenaline. Yeah, okay, I love you guys. Talk to you soon, and see you tomorrow for Miami day two, even though I've been here for 5 days now. Okay, I love you guys so much. See you soon. Good night. Good night, vlog. I'm so weird, but I'm so tired. Okay, bye guys, love you.
What is this ghetto ass shit going? What the?
Editors, he hated more than body hair.
What the hell, Zendaya? No.
This episode is giving me so much anxiety. I grew up on Shake It Up. This is not the Zendaya I know, but I love her forever. Oh wow, she's so awesome. Still not my biggest crush. Selena Gomez is, but she's getting there. Ooh, I should be running.